Make sure you guys smash that subscribe button if you guys are fans of the content being posted onto this channel to always be in the loop with more content similar to this, and be sure to hit the video up with a like if you're enjoying the content. And with that being said, let's begin. With Resident Evil Village looming over the horizon, now scheduled to be released on May 7th, the entire Resident Evil fandom is now talking about the brand new Resident Evil showcase that basically went on to feature additional gameplay for Resident Evil Village and additional features that we're bound to see when the game is released. But despite everything that was shown, is this potentially going to be the reintroduction of the horror elements within Resident Evil, having to follow through with Resident Evil 7 in delivering a very good game? Or is this game not going to be as promising as we think, only because of the elements having to be included? As joining me here today to further discuss the concept of the entirety of the Village showcase, as well as the game itself, is my good friend and YouTuber Mark. And I know Mark, I'm excited only because this game is taking place right after 7, and it's a continuational story, right? So we get to follow Ethan Winters, we have Chris Redfield in the mix. Now, in terms of what we saw from seeing these zombie-like creatures that are wielding swords in the dungeon, to watching and witnessing the giant ogre that's smashing through the entire village, like, what are your overall thoughts on the elements of the enemies? Only because there are multiple enemies that I really, really enjoy here, only because it's different. We don't really have a set enemy in having to be just the mold, because I think that's what killed Resident Evil 7, was outside of the bakers, all you really had was the mold, right? And I think that was really boring. But here we have something a little different. We have the inclusion of Mother Miranda, we have the inclusion of werewolves and hybrids and all types of monsters and creatures that are going to be lurking in the village. So what are your thoughts on the enemy aspect of the game? Do you think that the game is going to deliver when it comes down to giving us something solid to look forward to? Or do you think that perhaps something is missing and that the game kind of feels a little incomplete?
So after seeing the showcase on IGN's YouTube channel, like that, I mean, first off, it's kind of funny. The whole stream is like an hour of waiting, and then you get like 16 minutes of footage and discussion. But for what we got in those 16 minutes, I was actually very impressed. I know that there is pushback from a certain demographic within the fandom of Resident Evil that is not overly thrilled at the prospect of doing first-person perspective, but I like it. I don't have a problem with that. I think that there are plenty of games in the franchise that mix it up. You can do like a sort of a distant third-person view, or just like a just over the shoulder third-person view, but I think first-person is fine. Resident Evil 7 was a lot of fun for me. I really liked that, and it seems like this game is a direct tie-in, story-wise and visually, to that game. And I am very excited for what I had seen. I think visually it looks very stunning. It wasn't clear to me exactly what the footage was taken, like what platform it was from throughout the whole video. Maybe there was like a small lower third or something that said what it was, but I was too busy focusing on everything I was seeing to notice that. And it was beautiful. Like, it was truly beautiful. I really, really like the way the game looks. I like how we're in sort of like the Downton Abbey estate from hell. I think that looks awesome. I like that there is a whole new slew of enemy types. I think that's going to keep it fresh. Like, don't get me wrong, I am a massive zombie fan, huge zombie enthusiast, aficionado, whatever you want to call me. Anything with the undead, I'm all about. I mean, I've got my Steam page open with all my favorites like organized, and half of them are zombie related games, like from Resident Evil to State of Decay and everything in between. Like, I'm all about it. But I think it's nice that Resident Evil is showing you that, hey, like, it's not just necessarily all about pharmaceutical companies like accidentally like releasing a virus and now the town is infected. I don't get me wrong, I could get that from Resident Evil 1 to Resident Evil 101, and I probably would be okay with it. But I like that they're trying to do something a little bit different like they did with Resident Evil 7. I thought that was a fresh new spin on things, and I really enjoyed that personally. And I think this is going to be a lot of fun. The villain types are very unique, and it makes me wonder exactly what sort of like evil force that we're dealing with this time around. I think that it'll be neat to kind of explore and unlock those mysteries. I like the idea of werewolves now. It looked like there were some sort of like ghoulish dungeon type creatures that were a little bit different than what we've seen before. I don't know if we saw any like actual zombies per se, but there were definitely some enemies in there that looked like they were zombie-esque, right? And then we have like that massive ogre swinging that giant like sledgehammer thing, smashing his own enemies, like just not even having a care about them while he's trying to kill you. And it reminded me of Resident Evil 4, like the giants or the ogres or whatever those creatures were called, like when Leon was dealing with, I think, the Los Plagos, I forget what it is, but that sort of virus thing. So there's a lot of things in this game. It looks like they're grabbing from other Resident Evil titles. Like just being in this giant mansion feels like a sort of touch base on the first Resident Evil when you're in there, or we're dealing, like I said, with Resident Evil 4 enemy elements. And now we've got Resident Evil 7 story and plot tie-ins and the first person perspective and whole new enemy types. Like, I don't know, I guess as we've sort of experienced Resident Evil throughout the ages, we're looking at what, like 20, 30 years they were talking about. What was it, like the 25th anniversary or something like that? Like, that's a long time. And after everything that's happened, you know, we've dealt with zombies so much, and it still feels good, I think. But now that we're kind of like seeing that, hey, like there's a lot of other threats in this world that are looking to attack newish characters like Ethan Winters, and then returning characters like Chris Redfield, like the werewolves. Like, I'm like, damn, I didn't know that I wanted werewolves in Resident Evil until I saw it. And now I'm like, yes, I want that. That looks so good. If we can kill werewolves in a Resident Evil game, then I am totally stoked for that. That looks fantastic to me.
I definitely think that this is a huge step up from Resident Evil 7. Resident Evil 7 to me was really good, but there was something missing. I felt as though when playing the game a second or a third time, it either became a little too predictable or it just became a little too boring. But here, I think that you can replay the game many times over and still have a good time. I think that the enemies are really fun. I really do hope, though, that the enemies are different every single time you play the game, meaning you get swarmed, and it really becomes a difficult kind of way for you to either get out or escape. So, what are your thoughts on the element of Resident Evil 7 being borrowed? What are your thoughts on just the overall direction of where this game is going to go? And in your opinion, do you believe that with the whole first-person perspective, it's going to continue to work like this? Or, because there have been several people that have been complaining about, oh, it's not third-person, over-the-shoulder kind of style. It's not, you know, the traditional fixed camera angles. So, in your opinion, when looking at, I guess you could say, like, the runoff or near final product of Village, do you think that this game is going to be worth getting? Or do you think that perhaps maybe they still need to do a little bit of work on the game itself?
So when you're talking about Resident Evil 7 and you mentioned the word empty when you're talking about your experience, I think I know exactly what you're talking about. There's a certain expectation that I think fans of anything have when they're jumping into a continuation, a sequel, a prequel, a tie-in, an attachment, a spin-off, a remake, or whatever, a reimagining of the franchise that they are a fan of. When you're jumping into that, you sort of have a tendency, and when I say you, I mean like the fans as a whole, like I include myself in that statement when I say you, is that there's an expectation that we have with what is supposed to be in a Resident Evil game. So year over year, when we get new Resident Evil titles, there's a whole new feel to it. And I think the first three original Resident Evils are kind of the more, how do I say this, like the strongest or biggest pillars in the franchise, because with 4 and 5, it really changed everything. The third person perspective changed enough to where it made the game feel very, very different, I thought, from the original 1, 2, and 3 to 4 and 5. And when you're also not necessarily dealing with zombies anymore, it also changes the dynamic of your thought process with what you're dealing with. Like when you're dealing with zombies, I think from the game standpoint, like, and you really want to immerse yourself in the universe, the thing that you're thinking of is like, okay, here are these enemies that are completely mindless. They just want to like scarf down on my flesh. That's really all that they are. Like, this is the threat that I'm dealing with. And then the mutants. When you go into 4, 5, and 6, you're dealing with what seems to be kind of like a hive mind of people that are sort of all connected to this other sort of virus a little bit, and it changes the feeling of horror that you're in. Like, once you realize the enemy has a bit of a consciousness or intelligence, and they can act upon that, it changes it. For me, I feel like when I'm in games, and why I like zombies so much, is that zombies don't know what they're doing. They're just there to eat you alive, and that is horrifying to think about. When you're fighting an enemy that has intelligence, which gives them purpose, which gives them like strategy or some other higher level of thought, it changes the level of fear. So with 4 and 5, I feel like it did that for me immensely. And 4 and 5 also sort of abandoned the extreme puzzles that we saw in the first three games, I felt like. Because I feel as well, when I revisited Resident Evil on my channel, having just played them as part of the Mark After Dark segment on my YouTube channel, I realized that a lot of the puzzles there, they don't really make a lot of sense. Like, sure, yeah, you can stretch it, but that's really what it is. The puzzles are a stretch. When you get to 4 and 5, it's a little bit more action-packed. And then 6, I wasn't actually a huge fan, so I'm not going to talk about it. 7 is a whole different beast altogether. Resident Evil 7 is such a far cry different, like distance away from what the first collection of games is all about. You're a whole different character. I believe Ethan Winters was, I think it's his introduction, right? Is into 7. I don't think he appeared in the previous games, not that I recall. And so now you're with a whole new character dealing with a whole new threat. He's dealing with a family of people and a family of like supernatural abilities that you only find out has a connection in the grand scheme of Umbrella and everything else, like closer towards the end with some like little clues dripped and stuff in between. And yeah, like the family of Resident Evil 7, they are cannibals. So you're still dealing with like flesh eating people, but it's not the same. Like, it's not the same when you're dealing with just tons of mindless zombies. Now you're dealing with a handful of family members that have a unique set of abilities and they're just out to kill you. It changes the thing a little bit, and it didn't really feel like Resident Evil that much because of it. It just had Resident Evil slapped on the side of it, and that's, you know, what they went with. And plus, it was also, I think, yeah, the first Resident Evil that had the first person perspective natively. So, you know, there's obviously a lot of difference to consider with that. So if 8 is continuing with 7, for me, I loved 7 and I'm cool with that. But I understand where you would be coming from to say that it left you with a feeling of emptiness or like a hollow thing, because as a fan, I don't think it delivered that Resident Evil 1-2 punch that maybe you were looking for, because that's what I felt too. I feel like as the franchise evolves, we as fandoms, or fans rather, have to evolve with what, like we have to alter our experiences and expectations. And I don't think Resident Evil 7 was bad in any way. Again, I loved it, but it felt different to where I can understand why people felt wanting after the fact. Now, from what we've seen in Resident Evil 8, having not played it myself, you've actually had a little more experience with it than I have, because you have experienced the PlayStation 5 demo that's out now. You can kind of attest to the first person experience and what you're seeing a little bit better than I can. From what I'm seeing, I'm excited about it. But I have a feeling that maybe there might be a little bit more homage to some of the core entries in this series while still feeling a lot more like Resident Evil 7. So I think it'll be great. But if that's not what you're into, then I have a feeling that you might also experience a little bit of that missing element that you had with Resident Evil 7.
I really do hope that the game itself is going to speak volumes in kind of giving us more, because we have the brand new Resident Evil CGI movie coming out later this year called Infinite Darkness. That looks to be promising. So I think that Village is definitely a huge step up to 7. I mean, some people are going to go back and they're going to say, well, you know, after playing Village, of course, well, 7 is still better because you're at this plantation, you're dealing with a very small group of people, that being a family, so that kind of feels more terrifying. I mean, people are going to have opinions regardless, but in the comment section below, I want to get your thoughts on three specific things. Number one, do you think that this game is going to be the best Resident Evil entry, including far from the remakes and even 7? Number two, do you think that this is going to open the doors for a brand new story that's going to hopefully come out a lot sooner than how this game did compared to 7? And lastly, what are your overall thoughts on how this game is going to be once, of course, it comes out? So again, thank you all so much for watching, guys. Thank you all so much for your time. If, of course, you guys are new, then be sure to go on ahead and smash that subscribe button and turn on all notifications by clicking on the bell icon to never miss a single video on the channel. Tune back in for more. Slap this video up with a big fat thumbs up by hitting that like button down below, and we'll be seeing you all down in the comment section below. Have a great day, everybody, and take care. Peace.